Hello, lovely students. My name is Tiger. And I want to tell you something. So, how are you all? In our previous video, we talked about so many things related to different animals. And as you know, I belong to Kingdom Animalia. I want to tell you something. Do you remember yesterday's topic about animals' importance? Its types, food sources, and about their babies. Well, as we know, that chapter is totally related to reproduction in animals. So, I want you to ride with me in this important journey. Do you want to ride with me? Reproduction in animals. This is our current topic of today. So, we'll learn more about how do animals exactly reproduce? In our previous chapter also, you must have studied how plants reproduce. Okay? So do remember this always. Living things can reproduce. Non-living things, they won't be able to reproduce. And living things such as humans, animals, and plants, they can reproduce easily because they are having a life. Now, the process by which living organisms reproduce their young ones of their own kind. That is known as reproduction. Easy, na? Parent will reproduce a baby, newborn baby of their own kind. Okay? Now focus on this term, reproduction. Take it as a difficult word also. Okay, this reproduction means, re means again, and production means we are producing, we are generating something. Okay, so again and again, if we are producing something, only living things can reproduce. Remember this. If we are reproducing again and again, reproduction, if we are generating something again, that is known as reproduction. And also remember that different things, they have different reproductive system. Like animals, they have different reproductive systems, and humans, they do have different reproductive systems, and various animals just like reptiles or amphibians, they have different reproductive system. For example, female tigress will reproduce a small baby cub. Female sow will reproduce a small baby, also known as cub. All these animals, for example, dog, female dog will reproduce a baby pup. Okay, so all these animals, they are just for artificial purpose. This is just for, just to make you understand what the real purpose of reproduction is. They are not alive, they are not living beings, so they will not reproduce. They are just for artificial purpose, just for kind of a decoration material only. Only living things will reproduce again and again. Understood my word? All living things reproduce so that they continue to live on this earth for a long time. Otherwise, without reproduction, life would come to an end. For example, young ones replace the older or dying ones. Okay? Newborn babies, they replace the older or dying ones. And they feed themselves or by their parents, and they grow, more they grow, and then one at a time they will just reproduce again, and the process continues again and again. This is the whole process of reproduction. We can't stop this process, otherwise we'll be left with nothing in this world. Okay, and we'll be just having a barren land of this earth. Okay, so some animals lay eggs while others reproduce by giving birth directly. Okay, we have two different types of groups within this reproduction in animals. First one is egg-laying animals and second one is mammals. They both are totally different from each other. The first group, it lays egg. And the second group, it directly gives birth to its young one. You can find egg in a hole or in pebbles, nest, or maybe in water according to the animal. Okay. And you will find a mammal's baby inside its womb. They will not lay eggs at any cost. Now, so have a look on this first of all. These are your egg laying animals. Okay, egg laying, those who lay eggs. Salamander, snake, fly, fish, snail, turtle. These are your mammals, those who give birth to their young ones and those who feed their young ones with their own milk. Giraffe, deer, horse, sheep, squirrel, dog, cat, pig, lion, monkey, elephant, mouse, etc. and so on. Okay, so you will not forget that these are egg-laying animals and these are mammals. Now I'll tell you their characteristics. So I'll tell you one by one. Egg-laying animals are also called as oviparous animals and mammals are known as viviparous animals. Okay, so one by one we'll go with that. Egg-laying animal, they lay eggs with very hard shell. Eggs are very hard, hard-shelled eggs. Their shells are really hard so that they can be protected from outer environment. Egg-laying animals are cold as well as warm-blooded, but most of them are cold-blooded except pigeons or birds. They are warm-blooded because they need to keep their body warm, okay, for some further process. This process I'll tell you in our next video. Egg-laying animals, they won't have any kind of mammary gland, so they won't be able to feed their child. Their whole body is covered with feathers and scales. Birds are almost covered with feathers. And your snakes, they are covered with scales. They usually have dry kind of scales. They are having normal brain functioning as they are not that much well developed so that they can take care of their baby. And the last one is self-feeding by their babies. Their parents will not feed them except birds. Birds, they used to feed their babies from their beak-to-beak process, okay? They will take food from outside and they'll put inside the baby's mouth. Otherwise, rest of the animals' baby, they feed themselves. Now come to this mammal section. Mammals, they give direct birth to their young ones. Okay, as I've told you earlier also, all the mammals are warm-blooded because their body is warm and this warmth helps them to survive in all kind of temperature and in all kind of circumstances. They have mammary glands because they have to feed their babies. Mammary glands, and milk is produced by mammary glands. They have hair and external ears also, and they are having complex brains. They are very well developed so that they take care of their baby. They feed them, they can take care of them, they can take them along with themselves, and they feed their babies with their own milk. As I told you before, we are having two categories in this animal reproduction. First one is egg laying and second one is mammals. So egg laying are also known as oviparous and mammals, they are also known as viviparous. So in our oviparous section, we are having different kind of categories, different species you can say. First one is birds, second one insects, third one reptiles, and the fourth one is your amphibians. Okay, so example of birds, pigeons, parrots, sparrows, like so on. And insects you can say butterfly, moths, cockroaches, etc. And reptiles you can see here snake, lizard, and in amphibians, frogs, salamanders, toads, etc. Okay, now have a look on this one by one. Birds, egg-laying animals with a backbone, wings, and feathers, they are known as birds. Okay, they are egg-laying. They can fly using powerful muscles to flap their wings and have beaks. They are not having teeth, they have beaks. You can see here, they are wings, okay? So they can fly. Birds can fly. Birds fly just because of their wings. And the wings are really very powerful. That's why they travel from one place to another so easily. Now, insects. Small animals with many legs and they have wings and antenna. They are very small, but we can see them. And they too have wings and have antennas. You can see here cockroaches or butterflies. They too have antennas. Now, reptiles. Reptiles are cold-blooded. They are purely cold-blooded animals. They have dry skin covered with scales and they crawls on its belly, or they are having a small short legs also. Crawling, you know, no? Snake crawls. Okay. And lizard, it is having small, very short legs. So basically, this was about reptiles. Now, amphibians. They too are cold-blooded animals. They can live on both land and on and inside the water as well. Now I'll show you something. See, they all are reptiles. Most of them, they crawl and they have different way of moving. Okay, snake, you can see here, crocodile, salamander, frog, alligators, other kind of a snake, turtles. See, so these all are reptiles, and these are your amphibians. Okay, they have the capability to live under the water and on land as well. They can breathe through their skin also, and they are having well developed lungs also. Okay, so now look at this. This section belongs to egg laying animals and this section belongs to mammals. Understood this much? And you can see mammals, they give birth to their young ones and feed them with their own milk with the help of mammary glands, as we have started in this video only. For example, humans, cow, tiger, elephant, lion, gorilla, kangaroo, and so on. They are really very well developed. Mammals are having complex brain, they can think, they can act. They can do just like human beings, and the most developed ones are human beings. Okay, so this was all about your animal reproduction, about your egg laying animals and about mammals. Don't you forget this. You have to learn this very properly. That's it for today. I hope you all have understood this topic well and you will revise it very properly. You will do your work sincerely, but don't forget to take your homework. You will learn all the important terms, okay? By important terms, I mean to say you will learn birds, insects, reptiles, amphibians, mammals, okay? And you will write 5 examples of each of the following. You have to note down 5 examples of mammals, 5 for birds, 5 for insects, 5 for reptiles, and 5 for amphibians in your rough copy. Understood? And please do your work properly. If you're having any problem, do let me know in the comment box below. So it's hard to leave you, my dear lovely students. But please, if you're watching any video, like and subscribe to my channel for latest updates, for new notification. And do not forget to mention your name, class and your section as well in the comment box below. Okay. You have to write your name, and whatever homework I'm giving you after this video, that you have to note down in your rough copies, and the homework which will be provided in your school website, that you will note down in your fair copies. Till then, stay safe, stay happy, happy learning, and JMPS won't stop learning. Goodbye, take care.